Welcome back, Manon. Things around here are going to get even more hectic than they were before. The OSS is recruiting a new agent for a very specialized mission, and I think we've got our man. Remember that young ADC pilot who got you out of North Africa a year and a half ago? A lieutenant named Jimmy Patterson? I've kept my eye on him since then, and lo and behold, he just got himself nominated for the Medal of Honor. I'm going to see him tomorrow. If he decides to accept our offer, I want to make you his boss. My gut tells me the two of you will make a good team. Not all the details of his mission have been worked out yet, but I do know that it's got something to do with the Nazis' vengeance weapons program, which brings us to the subject of your next assignment, the V1 buzz bomb. We've received mixed intelligence over the past 2 years about their efforts to build a long-range, self-guiding flying bomb, so we weren't sure they'd ever be able to manufacture these weapons in mass quantities. Unfortunately, as we discovered this past week, they have. One of these V1s, powered by its pulse jet engine, can travel from its launch site in the French countryside to the heart of London in about 15 minutes. Some Spitfires on patrol have been able to knock down a few in midair, but for the most part, they get through to the city without any trouble. A few of these things have hit near my office at Whitehall, and I can tell you firsthand that it's not a pleasant experience. Some of the junior staff were at a pub that got hit. The impact crater was big enough to park a Liberty ship inside. No traces of the men were ever found. As soon as the 8th Air Force takes out a launch site, new ones spring up like weeds somewhere else. They've even air-launched a few of these missiles from specially modified Luftwaffe bombers. We've got to put a stop to this. Your mission is to disrupt their V1 manufacturing line and to secure the deployment information for the bombs that have already been shipped out. You leave tonight at 1900 hours. Be careful, Manon, or I'll have to find someone else to watch over this Patterson kid.
Manon, I'm surprised you made it.
Here are the plans for the factory. Let's go. It's not safe here.
Thank you.
Hold on! There are two sites along the way preparing for launch that have to be destroyed. In the meantime, make use of that 44 and get us some cover.
Thank you.
getting...
The ability to precisely hit a long-range target with an explosive warhead was only a theory when the war started. The Allies experimented with radio-controlled drones, while the Japanese used human kamikazes to inflict damage in the Pacific. At their Peenemünde research lab, however, German scientists developed the V-1 flying bomb. Almost 30 feet long and powered by a pulse jet engine, thousands of these vengeance weapons were launched from sites all over Western Europe, inflicting heavy damage. After the war, captured V-1s were used by the United States to leapfrog into a new realm of guided missile development. Though progress would still have the occasional setback.